This is the monthly digital planner for June that I have created using the Procreate app and the Keynote app. Hi friends, I'm Keizle from 6B Pixel. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, welcome. In this channel, I will share to you how I create digital planners with digital illustrations as the main design element. And if you're interested in those and also want to create your own digital planner, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time a new video comes out. If you have watched my previous video where I showed you how long it takes me to create a digital planner from scratch using my iPad, then you might also have seen the process on how I illustrated this digital artwork. And in this video, I'm going to show you the process on how I created the weekly pages and the digital planner for the month of June. The first thing that I did is to make the shape that I want my design element to have and use the clipping mask. I also added a shadow effect using the Gaussian blur to make the design element pop. For the days of the week, I'm drawing this paper and adding a tape element design on top. When drawing straight lines in Procreate, you can use the drawing guide for that. I almost always use it and I love that feature, and you can turn that on by going to the action, which is the wrench icon, and under canvas, turn on the drawing guide. Then on the current layer in the layer menu, tap on the thumbnail of the current layer and turn on the drawing assist. I also added some grid lines because I prefer having some guides when writing. And after creating this one, I just duplicated them 4 times because there are only 5 days for the first week of June. I start my week on Monday, so if you're following along, keep that in mind. Then I used the add text function in Procreate for the title and wrote down the days of the week. For this space here, I decided to add a habit tracker for this week. I've been tracking habits lately, and sometimes I add them as tasks because I enjoy checking them off every time I do them. But since the first week of June has already passed when I created this digital planner, I just decided to make a space here. Since I only have one digital illustration that I'm going to use for the month of June, I want to maximize it and use it in every page of the digital planner. But to create an illusion of variety, I'm using different shapes and different designs to do that. So for the second week of my June digital planner, I decided to use circles. I recently been thinking about the designs I made for my bullet journal years ago when I was using paper and pen to plan and journal, and I want to incorporate those designs on my digital planner now. And I used to have different page designs every week, and I miss that kind of variety. That is why, although I am using the same illustration, I'm changing it up every page. And while I work on the weekly page, I want to ask if you prefer weekly pages or daily pages, or do you use both? For me, I prefer using weekly pages to be able to see all the things that should be done in a week, and it is easier to create them and still have some variety on all the pages because there are only like 4 to 6 weeks per month. If I have to design 30 different pages for just a monthly planner, I don't know if I am up to that. A yearly planner that I can probably work on, though I'm not even sure if I will, because illustrating, although enjoyable and I love doing it, it would take quite a long time to create 13 illustrations in just a few months. It would probably take me 6 months or more with the current pace I have right now. But you know what? We'll see. Maybe I will create a yearly planner with different illustrations per month. For the third weekly page for the month of June, I just want the illustration as a whole to just be there in the page. So I just resize it and place it in the lower left corner of the page. Then I added the rounded corner rectangles for the daily planning space. I left the upper left corner empty because I plan to add the design and shapes using the Keynote app. That space will have my habit tracker. This is why planning before you start creating your digital planner is a must, so you know if you can add the elements in the Procreate app or in the Keynote app, and which of the apps will make the process faster. So for the next weekly page, I am adding this vertical daily spaces and using the clipping mask on the illustration layer so that the illustration will just be used as a background design. And of course, again, adding the lines. I prefer using these vertical daily spaces when I feel like I will be needing some inspiration or drive to just do things, because those times I add to my to-do list the simplest task just to say I did something for myself, like taking a bath, cleaning my room, taking my vitamins, and sleeping before midnight, and some other simple tasks I need to do to live and survive. So for the last weekly page, I thought I needed 8 spaces, but there are just 4 days, so after realizing that, I will remove the other 4 and instead add a space where I can write down my plans for next month. After designing the weekly pages, I'm going to export them as PNG files so I can use them as photos in the Keynote app. Now in the Keynote app, I am using the basic white theme, although I'm going to remove all the default elements in the slide. I'm going to use the same dimensions that I use in my yearly digital planner that I made a few videos ago. I will add the link of that video below, so if you want to see the process and how I made my 2022 digital planner, you can check it out. After setting the dimensions of the digital planner, using the slide layout, I'm going to add the different pages that I have created in the Procreate app. To add pictures, use the plus icon in the upper right and select the photo icon and then tap photo or video and look for the pictures that you want to add and then tap them. So if you have watched my previous digital planner design and creation videos, you know that I almost always add an extra page for journaling, and in this monthly digital planner, I'm going to add an extra page after every weekly page. I love journaling and it's really helpful for me, and I find writing my thoughts to be relaxing, especially nowadays. After setting up the pages, if you want to optimize your digital planner, you can check the video about the ultimate tip for a lag-free digital planner that I have posted a while back, and I will also add the link of that in the description box below. After optimizing the digital planner, I am now going to add the links. I'm also adding the habit tracker in the empty space in my third weekly page, and I use shapes and tables to do that. After checking that the links that I have added are correct, I exported the digital planner and added it to the GoodNotes app. If you want more videos like this one, or if you have any questions, comment them down below. I'm Keizle, and until next time, bye!